This is Radio TV Phono Nut, and today we're going to look into something that's a little bit newer than what you're accustomed to seeing on this channel. This is a Denon CD player and cassette recorder from December 2001. This is a commercial grade model, and it was made in Japan, not China, so that's a good sign. But here's the deal with it. This belongs to my church. It's the main CD player that they use in the sanctuary. And last Sunday, they played a disc on it, took the disc out, and then the CD tray wouldn't close. And then Wednesday, I was approached about fixing it. And I told them up front that I'll do what I can, but I'm not making any guarantees. I said, you know how it goes. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. And they said, fair enough, just do what you can with it. So we're going to do what we can with it. I asked him, do they ever use the cassette side anymore? And he said, very rare. He said, there's one lady that brings music in on a cassette. And he said, we've already told her that you'd better come into the 21st century, because it's probably not going to be too much longer that we're not even going to have a way to play a cassette, as in if this thing takes a dump completely. And on the back we have our standard RCA jacks as well as XLR connectors, and we have a switch for balanced and unbalanced. Here's the inside. I've already removed the CD mechanism, which I'll show you in just a second. Okay, once I tore it all apart, this is what I discovered. The belt was lying loose in here, as was this gear here that had slipped off of the shaft here that the gear is supposed to reside on. And the reason that happened, because it looks like this shaft is broken off. There was some kind of retainer clip or something here that just broke off. You know how old plastic does when it gets old. Now, getting parts for this would probably be difficult to impossible, because you know how it is. The older stuff that we work on this channel can often be fixed with off-the-shelf parts that are readily available, but these later pieces of electronic equipment often uses specialized parts that were made for a specific model, and then when that model is discontinued, and so are the parts. So I got to figure out a way to try to fix this if we can. About the only thing I know to do is just run a pin or an old component lead or something down in that hole and epoxy it on, and that way the gear can't slide off of the top of this plastic post here, and hopefully it'll work. There's the loading belt that I found loose inside. Now, even though this thing is almost 20 years old, you might say that's a good run, but here's something else to consider. It's not like this thing has been in constant service every day for the past 19 some odd years. This thing has only been used most likely for a little while on Sunday morning. Maybe for choir practice on Wednesday night and Sunday night, maybe. But you get the idea. This thing hasn't had a ton of use on it, so it's just a case of old plastic that cracked and broke, and that's that. Now let's get in here and try to fix it. All right, here's what I did. I took a piece of a lead off of an old resistor and bent it around and stuck it down in the hole. And I also soldered the lead so it would stay in the shape that I bent it in. I'm going to put a little bit of JB Weld down in that hole, the center of that shaft. And whenever it cures, that should stay in place and prevent this gear from ever sliding up off the top of that shaft again. It should work okay until the shaft decides to break off from the other plastic here, and then we'll just have to cross that bridge when they get to it. But given this thing is 19 years old, they probably better be thinking about getting another CD player anyway, because this thing's not going to last forever. CD players are not like turntables. They usually don't last that long. Alright, there we go. I didn't use that much JB Weld because I didn't want any spill over it. It might weld this gear to the shaft. So we're going to let this cure. And then once we make sure this is all stable and secure, we'll put our belt back on it and put it all back together and see what happens. Okay, we got the belt back on and the epoxy looks to be cured enough to keep that gear from, keep that little homemade pin I made in place and keep the gear from sliding up. So let's go put it back in the CD player and see what happens. And now something's hanging the tray up. So let's take it back apart and see what that might be. Okay, I'll remove the actual optical pickup assembly out of the tray itself so I could get a better look and make sure that wasn't something hitting this optical pickup assembly, but that's not the case. It's still not closing. Well, it looks like our gear got out of time. I took the tray out, and I really don't like doing that because it's held in place with little plastic tabs, and I can just envision them breaking off each time I have to remove this. And I got the gear, moved the position of the gear, and I was able to slide the tray back in there. Now, if I hadn't already said it, I'm not a... CD players are not my forte. I've probably done more to this one than I've ever done to any in my life. Okay, we got it all back together. Now let's go try once again to see if this will work. And, you know, I really should have checked to make sure that tray would slide back in the first time before I put this back in there, but I didn't, so... But now it does, so let's go put it back in and see if we can load a disc. Alright, I haven't screwed everything back down yet. But it looks to be working. Alright, let's go get the screws and button this thing up. Okay, here we are back together, and we're connected to an Alrad, sort of cheapo tube amplifier, not as cheapo as the one we worked on the other day. This one actually has a power transformer and uses just a single 6BM8 tube per channel. We have controls for tone left, tone right, volume left, volume right, and a stereo phono auxiliary or mono phono and auxiliary switch, although it sounds better in the phono position. Let's put a disc in and see what happens. Here's the final test. If it's going to mess up, it's going to wait to do it until after I've reassembled everything. I'm going to tell them when you close it, use the open and close button. Don't go pushing on that tray. Okay, now play. There we go.
I hate to say it, but I told you so. Don't mind my preaching to you.
Good time.
Rubber ball.
what you'll ever do. But I get on for
track 10 is supposed to be queued up. Let's see what happens. Oh, yeah. Let's go to track 12, queue. Open. At one time there was a little escutcheon or snap-on thingamadoodle over this tray. That was gone when they handed it to me, so I don't know nothing about that. But yeah, we got it all back together. No screws left over, no empty holes with no screws in them. So yeah, I think this thing's ready to go.